How you going? Welcome to another video about what's happening next week. Paul Branson here, Kingsford Smith School Principal. For those of you who don't know me, hopefully you do by now. Next week we start our face-to-face teaching. We transition for some of our students next week, starting with our preschool kindies, ones, twos and sevens. And as much as possible, we'll have students with their regular teacher in their regular rooms and with their regular timetable, as much as possible. Students who are registered and have been attending our hub may also attend in as a supervised student, basically doing the same sort of work they've been doing over the last couple of weeks. They're learning from home but at school. The reason that I made this video is I want to talk to you about the members of our community, our students, our parents, our teachers, feeling safe at school and also being safe at school. And it's really important that our teaching and our non-teaching staff have some measures in place for that to happen. So we've increased the cleaning regime at the school so that all our surfaces are being cleaned regularly throughout the day and in the evening, and that's to reduce the risk of surface infection. We've also relocated some of our staff into the rooms to ensure that our adults are keeping their social distancing of 1.5 metres apart from each other and any one enclosed space less than one person for every 4 square metres. Now, the social distancing in schools does not apply to students, but it does apply to all other adults. That includes you as community members. So there's a couple of key things that I'm asking from you, and it's really important that we do this for all of us so that we feel that we're not putting each other at risk and that there's some confidence in our community. Drop off in the morning, in particular, please drop off, if you're dropping off your child in the drop-off area, don't park in that area, just drop your students off because we want to make sure that we have a flow of traffic. We're trying to reduce the congregation of large groups of people. So if you're going to drop your child off, then don't park in that area, just drop them off in the drop-off zones. Unless you have a prior arrangement, in other words, you've had a conversation with myself or one of the other senior executive in the school, we're asking families not to enter the school buildings themselves. Now, we realise that some families may need to come to the front office for particular reasons, but unless there's an absolute reason, we're happy for you to call and do other things instead, but for all other buildings, you shouldn't be entering those buildings unless you've had a conversation with myself or one of the other senior execs. For our primary students, all the drop-off and pick-ups will be done in the main courtyard. So we're asking that you pick up your student there in the afternoon. They'll be released by their classroom teacher and they'll be picked up by their classroom teacher. We ask that you keep 1.5 metres away from each other because in an outdoor space we don't need to worry about the 4 square metre rule, but we do ask that you keep out of arm's length from each other, but also from your teacher. So bring your student to where your teacher will be waiting just before it's time to go in, and then they can then go and walk over to their teacher from a reasonable distance of 1.5 metres. I've had a couple of frequently asked questions, so I'm going to answer those now. One of those is, can all students return next week? Look, because we don't have a full complement of our staff due to workforce vulnerability, and to also give us time to plan, we're asking that you try and stick to the staged return of students that has been agreed on by the ACT Education Directorate. Look, families that, for whatever reason, have used the site, obviously may use the site, and if you have a need, we certainly won't be turning any students away. And I want to make that message really clear. However, to help us and to help the students transition in a reasonable way, please try and stick to that timetable. Some of you asked about canteen. Our canteen has obviously been shut during this period of time. We will have a canteen operating, but there'll be no counter service as such for at least this transition period and possibly a little longer. We're still negotiating that. But you may be able to use the FlexiSchools. If you haven't got a FlexiSchools account, you can get the FlexiSchools app, or you can log on to FlexiSchools, and it's exactly how it sounds, flexischools.com, and there you'll be able to order a limited menu, but a menu for your student if you can't provide them with food throughout the day, and that will be delivered to the students' classrooms. Some of you asked about sanitizer and about hygiene. Certainly we'll be continuing to make sure there's plenty of signage about making sure we wash our hands correctly and that if we sneeze or cough, and if it's a serious one, obviously we'll be talking about that in a moment, but just a single sneeze or a cough, about covering our mouths, etc. We will be providing sanitizer in the classrooms, and each teacher will have their own supply for their own personal hygiene, as well as we'll be providing some for the classrooms. Sickness is a big one, and this is where I really do need your support. We know that regardless of whether it's COVID-19 or any of the other sort of colds and flus that come around this time of year, it can be devastating for staff, and particularly when we're on a limited staff as we are at the moment, if we lose people because of sickness and that they can't attend work. So I've been given the authority to instruct staff if they are unwell, or anybody else in our school, if they're unwell, that they must leave the grounds and must go home. This includes parents and community members. If they show signs of sickness, I will direct them to leave. Also, I will ask that if your child is sick, whether it be symptoms of COVID-19 or not, we will isolate them and then we will be calling you and asking to pick them up. This is a really difficult one, I know, for lots of families who have work commitments, but you have to have that conversation with your work that if my child is sick, they cannot stay at school. We can't hold them here for the rest of the day, that sort of thing. Our staff and our community has to feel confident that there's no sickness within the school. So more so than ever, there'll be no exceptions to that. I will be calling and we will be asking that your child stays home if they are ill. And if they're already ill in the morning, please don't send them, because we will send them straight back to you. I'm sorry that that's an inconvenience, but it's really essential that we have that confidence for our workforce. If you have any other questions, feel free, as usual, to email at info@kss.act.edu.au or call the front office and I can answer some questions. Till next time, see you then.